Hi, Brian. I have a friend who loves their Pilot Plumix, but when I saw her using it for the first time, I had no idea what it was. Turns out it's a pretty good pen, but everyone seems to overlook it. I think it's because the Metropolitan is so popular. In your opinion, what are the five most underrated fountain pens? Okay, let's talk about the Plumix for just a hot second. Plumix is a decent pen. I have nothing particularly wrong with this pen, but you're right, it is not an extremely popular pen. It uses the same nib style as what is on the Metropolitan and the Kakuno and the Prera and the Penmanship, which I don't carry. And actually, as I'm looking at it right now, I'm realizing I actually had swapped this nib and I don't have the natural nib that comes on this pen. It comes with a stub nib. So this is actually not the nib that normally comes on the pen, but it just comes right off pretty easily. You can swap it out. So a lot of times what people are doing when they want this pen is they'll take this pen with its stub nib, yank it out, swap it onto a Metropolitan since it's the same design. Ta-da! And that's what they will buy the Plumix for, is just the stub nib, because it's an inexpensive pen. As a pen itself, the Plumix is kind of interesting looking. It's really a little bit more designed as a desk pen. It's kind of long and very tapered, and it does post, but it's just a little bit odd. It doesn't have a clip. You know, it's just got these kind of wings. I call it the squid pen affectionately, because that's kind of what it ends up looking like. It's got a couple different colors that it's available in, but it's not a bad pen. It's just not necessarily like everybody's preference. So it's really not the pen for everyone, you know, especially with the one nib option, with the stub nib, which some people, they want that, but not a lot of people at the onset necessarily want to dive into that. I do think it's a great starter stub nib, so that is really a nice thing there, but I think the Metropolitan just ends up being way more popular as a starter pen, partly because there's a lot of different colors, partly because it also comes with a converter, whereas the Plumix does not. And it comes in more conventional nib sizes. So I don't think that the Plumix is going to dethrone the Metropolitan anytime soon. But you asked me about what are some other pens that I feel are underrated. So this is not like an official kind of exhaustive list. I would probably like really put a lot of thought and intention to coming up with a more exhaustive list, but this is kind of just what I came up with earlier today as I was prepping for this video, being somewhat sick as I am. So this is just kind of a little bit off the top of my head, but I have some pens that I think would be good to kind of shout out. And some of these are not even unpopular. I just think that they're a really great value, or perhaps should be even more widely known than they are. Metropolitan is very widely known. I would include this on my list, except I think it is very popular, and rightfully so. Other pens like the Safari and things like that, I think they are popular for good reason. I don't think that they're underrated necessarily, so to speak. I think that these other five that I've picked here are perhaps a little more underrated. Okay, first one that I have is the Pilot Varsity. This is actually the old style of Varsity. It's a little more snazzy looking now, but it's a pre-loaded, pre-inked pen. Very inexpensive, it's under $4, and it actually writes really nicely, especially for that price of pen. It comes preloaded, but you can actually yank it apart and refill it up kind of as an eyedropper pen, so you can get more than one use out of it if you hack it. And it's just a great toss around pen. It's a really good pen, especially if you are into fountain pens and you want to get other people into it. For a few bucks, you can buy it. It's very easy to get somebody in. They can write for a long time without having to think too much about cleaning and maintenance and stuff like that. And if they get used to writing with it, maybe you can get them kind of hooked in and then, you know, go deep dive into the whole pen maintenance, cleaning and changing and inking up and all that kind of stuff. So that I think is a great pen. And it definitely has a good reputation, but I don't think it's probably as widely known about because it's disposable, that I think it's a really, really great pen that probably could get a little more attention. Another one is a Pilot Parallel. Now this one is actually fairly popular, especially, you're on Instagram, and a lot of folks on Instagram, a lot of artists and calligraphers and stuff like that love the Parallel, but it's a bit of an odd pen. It looks kind of strange, and doesn't look like your average pen, so I think that tends to scare most people off. The interesting thing about the Parallel is that it uses a typical, you know, ink feeding mechanism, but instead of having a feed with a nib on top of it, it actually uses two plates that come together that the ink feeds through. It still uses capillary action, but it's not your conventional nib and feed setup as you would have on a conventional fountain pen. So it makes it so that it does a really great job at calligraphy. So you get very thin cross strokes, very fat down strokes. It comes in four different sizes that are demarcated by the different colors that they have. And it's a very inexpensive pen, around $10. So I think it's a really, really nice pen, especially if you're trying to do hand lettering and things like that. I know, had my wife known about this when we got married 10 years ago, she probably would have gotten into these and experimented with this when she was doing our wedding invitations and stuff. Really good pens for that, especially if you're already into fountain pens and you're just wanting to get into some more calligraphy style stuff. I think the Parallel is a great pen. Now, it is fairly popular for that purpose, but even still, I think a lot of people aren't aware of this pen just because it looks so different than, say, you know, a 912 stub nib. Next pen I have is another Pilot. Pilot's got a lot of pens, and I think some of them are actually very underrated. The E95S. This is a kind of an unconventional design of a pen. It looks kind of vintage, kind of throwback. And it's a little bit more of a pocket pen. And you know, it's got this burgundy and ivory color. It's also got a black one, which is a little more conventional looking. It's got an inlaid nib here, or partially inlaid nib at least. And it's got this very interesting kind of posting you know, feature, where it's got the cap, which is most of the length of the pen. And then when you put it on the back, it kind of extends the length of it. So it's very interesting. A lot of, you know, it kind of, to me, feels like a lot of vintage pens used to have kind of designs like this. These days, the proportions of pens tend to be a little more similar. You know, threaded cap and, you know, the body's a lot longer and stuff like that. But this one's got a really long grip. You know, it's got the cap, which is also very long. To me, I think it looks kind of elegant and stuff. And it is not like a cheap pen, but it's definitely on the lower end of a gold nib pen. And it writes really great. It's got a fairly soft nib for not having a soft nib advertised. But I really like this pen a lot. And I think that it could get a little more attention. It's not unpopular, but I think it's just kind of unconventional. So it's not on most people's radar. Excuse me. That was a cough, not a sneeze. Forgive me, everybody who was on the line mic here. All right. This is the Platinum 3776, which is a great pen. They actually just came down in price. And several different color options, got a great cap sealing mechanism. This pen is very comparable in, you know, its price range and features to the Pilot Custom 74, Lamy 2000, you know, Pilot Vanishing Point. Anyone considering kind of more of that entry-level gold nib pen, I think the 3776 should be a contender. Now, it was previously priced a little higher, you know, probably about $20, $30 higher than it used to be. It's lower in price now, closer to the $150 range. So I think this is a pen that should get on more people's radar. Now, the nib itself writes a little bit differently than other fountain pens do, you know, especially like Pilot. They tend to make their nibs a little springy. This one's a little stiffer, and it's got a little bit of feedback to it. So I think that is maybe part of the reason why it's not quite as popular. But a lot of the people that I've gotten comments from who own these, they really love them once they use them. It's just doesn't get quite as much gushing love as some of the other standbys like the Lamy 2000 and stuff like that. So. And maybe just because it's a more classic design, doesn't stand out quite as much. But I do think it's something that is worth taking a look at. And the last one that I have here probably doesn't need a whole lot of introduction or promotion, but I'll just shout it out because I think it's such a good value, is the Twisby Eco. Now, I don't always have great stock of these, and it's you know, it's been around for about a year or so. And it's just a really phenomenal value of a piston fill pen under $30. It writes well. It does tend to have some flow stuff when you first fill it up if you aren't than untwisting it, just because the way the design is here, you got to fill it up and then kind of get the air out of the feed, which is pretty easy because you can see it's clear. You got to get the air bubble and stuff out of the feed before it'll really write with consistency. So it gets a little bit of a bad rap for having some flow issues. So it's really more of a, you have to kind of know how to fill it and then use it. Or if you, you know, if you have some flow issues, it'll eventually kind of work itself out once the air gets out of the feed. But if you know that little tip, it helps a lot. But it's a phenomenal pen. If I was a college student, this is a pen that I would really look to because it's a huge ink capacity, pretty durable pen, and it just writes really nicely and has some good nib options too. So I think it's also really good, still gets some good recognition, but you know, especially anybody looking at any of the piston filling pens, that one is an underrated one for sure.